Hello, in this tutorial you're going to learn how the different components are used and how they interact with each other and also how to customize them. What I am planning to do is to recreate the obsidian white template you are currently looking at on your screens. Now let's start and open a new project. I'll call my project VideoApps Tutorial. Before you start working in VideoApps Studio, it's better to have your visual design completed and your images ready to use. You also need to know what size your interactive video playlist needs to be to fit perfectly on your website. In my case, I'll change the canvas size to 980 by 372 pixels. Now our canvas has a proper size and we are ready to add the background. Drag an image component on the stage and add an external image to it. I have prepared all the images I need for this tutorial in advance, so now I'm going to upload them to the library. You can upload more than one image at a time. Just select all of the images and click upload. As you can see, I have many images in my library. I'm going to use the search engine to find the image I need faster. Here it is, and now I can use it for my background. I will change the component name to background, and I'll also give it width and height same as the canvas. I'll place my background on 0, 0. Now we need a player, a playlist, and a control for the playlist. For the playlist control, we can choose between tabs and drop down. In this case, I'll go with the drop down. Because I have made my design in advance, I know where each component has to be located and also its size. When I create videos or players for the web, I usually make them widescreen with 16:9 ratio. I'm going to change the width of my player to 480 and the height to 270. I will also change the position to 10:10. This square of 480 by 270 is where the video will be displayed. We have to take into account the height of the player's skin, which is 20 pixels. We have to add these 20 pixels to the height of the player for everything to fit perfectly. The new height of the player is 290. Now I have to change the size of the playlist. My playlist will be located on 510 and it will be 470 pixels wide and 336 pixels high. With the playlist selected, if we go under common properties, we can set the item size for each thumb. My thumbs will be 230 pixels wide and 103
for the height.
We can also set the spacings between the terms. I'll set 10 for horizontal spacing and 10 again for vertical spacing. We have to point our playlist to the player. To do that, under the player property, select your video player. You can also select the default playlist. I'll select Simple TV Channel 1. We also need two buttons for scrolling our videos forwards and backwards. Just go under Visual and drag two buttons on the stage. When the button is selected on the left side under Properties, you can change its label. We will make this button Previous Videos and the second one Next Videos. Now I'll show you how to tell the buttons to scroll the playlist when they are pressed. With the Previous Videos button selected, click on Button Action. For target component, choose Playlist 1. Under Handle, type scroll_prev, and on Enabled, type can_scroll_prev. What we did here is actually very simple. We connected the button to the playlist. We told the button to scroll to the previous section when it's being pressed. And can scroll prev, what it does is it disables the button in case there is nothing to scroll. So if you don't have enough videos to scroll, the buttons will be disabled. The Previous Videos button is ready. Now let's fix the next videos. Select the button, choose Playlist 1 again, but this time type scroll_next, and for Enabled type can_scroll_next. We also need to fix our dropdown. First I'll make it a little bit larger so we can see it better. Then on the left side under Playlist Management, select Playlist 1 for list control. For initial playlist, I'll select Simple TV Channel 1. If we leave the Load All checkmark on, all playlists we have in our Streaming Video Provider account will be loaded. Let's leave it as it is for now and add a search box to our project. I will move the playlist dropdown further down and I'll drag a search component on the stage. I'm going to make the search box background visible and also its corner radius equals to 4. Actually 4, not 5. I also need two buttons, one to act as a search button and the second one to act as a reset button for the search engine. I'm going to call the search button search. And the reset button, reset. Then we'll move them to the right. Now we need to make our search box actually work. On the left side, with the search box selected, for playlist choose playlist 1 or whatever your playlist is called. For go button I will use the search button I created, and for the reset button I will use reset. We are ready to test our newly created interactive playlist. Make sure you save your project before you do that. After it's saved, click on Preview and the preview will be generated. I selected sample TV channel playlist 1 for my initial playlist because I knew that I'll have more than 6 videos on it. Now I can text the buttons. As you see, the previous videos button is disabled because this is the first page and there is nothing to scroll in the left direction. If we click on next videos, you'll see that the videos are scrolling. When there is nothing to scroll there too, it becomes disabled. We can also test our dropdown. We can switch between different playlists. We can play the videos. And also, we can use a search engine to find a video we're looking for. Let's try with Kung Fu Panda. And here it is. To clear the search result, click on reset and all other videos will be back again. Now you know how to set up your components to work with each other. In the next part of this tutorial, I'll show you how to customize the different components and make them look nicer. Thanks for watching.